The native tongue family consists of De La Soul, Jungle Brothers, a tribe called Quest. But lo and behold, there's always a black sheep in the family. The black sheep, the lowlifes of the family tree. The doodle-eating, vomit-tasting, pee-drinking, jelly donut-making, hole-slapping, kitty cat licking, cesspool swimming, premarital sex having, you know, the whole nine. So run for the hills and hide your hoes.
You gotta know, I mean, I know all the listeners here are well educated on hip hop culture, so you have to know who black sheep are. If you don't know, I'm gonna just push you to Google it, because I don't like to always tell folks information. Yeah. I feel like you should be aware of the same way we know about American history or global world history. We should know about hip hop history.
You don't know that you're a legend? Yeah, you are a regular dude, but you still a legend.
Like, I kind of had to deal with cats calling me old school. You know, I'm like, you know, like, you know, I'm not old school. You know what I'm saying? Like, right. You know, I'm, you know, basically the same age as some of the cats that are on the charts right now. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But it's just that, you know, I did a piece of work some years ago. But I hope that's something that we also can get away from, because other forms of music really aren't held to that criteria.
Right.
You don't really look at, you know, forms of rock and roll or forms of, you know, soul or whatever, and, you know, not and categorize it as something that's old or something that you don't want to be affiliated with. You know, Rolling Stone can, you know, sell more units right now than, you know, damn near anyone.
So today, we are going to be doing a try not to sing challenge. So the rules are, you can't sing, but you also can't dance or move your head to the beat, and you can't lip sync along to the music.
Yeah, man. That's what's up.
This is my first one. I'm gonna win this one.
No, you heard the
hummus.
I like vaguely know this song.
This one's a little simpler to not like sing along.
The choice is yours.
You can get with this, or you can get with that.
Or you could get with this, or you could get with that.
You can get with this.
I don't honestly know this song, so.
Does that count as dancing?
It does.
Ah!
Engine number 9 on the New York Transit line. If my train goes off the track, pick it up, pick it up.
Oh,
pick
shit, I did it.
Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up.
Back on the scene.
Ooh, it makes you want to jump around.
If you're not headbanging, what are you doing?
Down for the settle. Won't play rock. Won't play the pebble. Open the door, you best believe we're sliding through it swiftly.
I don't even know that song, but it has a nice beat.
But yeah, with that being said, I don't think I've heard Black Sheep before.
I don't know anything about these dudes, never heard of them, so just give me any information. Give me any information about the track, give me any information about the group.
Although the name sounds familiar, I'm thinking maybe I might have seen them perform on like the end episode of In Living Color.
Black Sheep, I've heard one song by them. Of course, that would be The Choice Is Yours, you know. Pretty sure everyone's heard that one.
It looked like from the thumbnail, there's probably two people in it. Definitely a different type of name, Black Sheep. Ready to see what these dudes about.
Y'all know, anybody that lived in New York in the 90s and went to house parties, when a certain part of this song comes on, everybody just gets low. And they just rock out to this joint. Let's get to this.
I don't know what you're talking about, but okay.
They're gonna see you in a minute.
I'm Seth Tom. I'm standing here in the middle of downtown Sanford. This spot where these two tracks cross is very important to the history of Sanford. If these two tracks didn't cross in this exact spot, then Sanford as we know it would be a very different place.
So where did the story start for Dres?
I don't even know where you were born.
I was born in Queens, New York.
Okay, where
in Queens?
Yeah, I'm from Astoria Project.
My stepfather was in the Army and moved us as a family to North Carolina.
Where in North Carolina?
I spent 1 year in a small town called Sanford.
Downtown, Main Street, Sanford. Those words conjure up ideas of the typical sleepy American small town. But we sensed that downtown Sanford had more of a story to tell. So we hit the streets to learn more through a variety of man-on-the-street interviews. We also asked participants what color they felt best reflected downtown Sanford. And reddish-brown was a recurring choice, perhaps a subtle nod to Sanford's proud history and heritage as the brick capital of the USA.
Because I moved from New York and, you know, I kind of had these preconceived notions about Carolina and, you know, just the racism, you know what I'm saying? It's an all-black high school and I was blown away that everybody looked just like me and being smart was the cool thing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, if you was running around nutting up, you was kind of frowned upon. Like, cats wasn't even really messing with you because you was kind of stopping them from being who they was supposed to be.
Wow.
You know, literally. And it gave me a dope insight to myself. It kind of pushed me to, you know, to take school seriously and look at things beyond, you know, my corner.
So how you meet Mr. Long?
So senior year of high school, my mom moves me and my sister to Sanford.
Mm-hmm.
And, I meet this kid named Stan. Stan's from New York. And Stan had turntables, mics, and equipment in his crib.
Stan's crib was the crib.
Was the crib.
Right.
So literally every day after school, I was at Stan's house and we cut in, you know what I'm saying, making tapes. So every day, this little dude would come through and his name was Shorty Doo-Wop. That's Mr. Long. He was probably a nicer DJ than everybody that was coming through the room. He was really, really gifted. Really, really, really gifted.
Action for all those that talk down on the three. Take this. Ha, ha, ha. Come
on. Yeah. Well, I started DJing when I was about 11 years old. And I saw, you know, my cousin is into this DJing thing. He's starting to scratch. I'm like, I want to do that too. I see him getting down. I want to see what I can do with this. And I learned how to scratch, you know, the backspin and that type of thing. And we kind of fed off of each other on a competitive level. And we just sharpened each other's skills that way.
So there was a show in Raleigh. Mm-hmm. So we got a little pull in the state because, you know, we're like the New York cats that live there. So we're able to get Long opportunity to cut before the show.
Okay.
Long was so small that he had to stand on milk crates to stand above the turntables. But just mad fast, mad nice, mad precise, very precise as a DJ.
Mm-hmm.
And Red Alert is there, and Red is kind of blown away.
Shout out to Red.
Yeah, big shout out.
I love me some Red.
Gotta love Red. You know what I'm saying? Gotcha.
Yeah.
Watch my hand.
He saw me on the set. Was like, yo, dude, you're really good on that. You do your thing and you're young. So, yo, check this out. If you ever come to New York, give me a call. I took his number. That next year, like 85, 86, the summer, I called Red, let him know I was in New York. He told me where to come.
There's a special award I would like to present. Bum of the Year. Bum of the Year goes to my man, DJ Red Alert. Red Alert is in the house. Word up. Oh.
So, when Long goes up...
Red must have been impressed.
He really was. Mm-hmm. Literally was. Red takes him under wing, runs with him, has him in the studio. You know, Mike G's nephew, has him in the studio with the Jungle Brothers while they're making their first album.
Okay.
So he's meeting the Jungle Brothers at that point.
Getting connected.
Educated man from the motherland. You see, they call me a star, but that's not what I am. I'm a Jungle Brother, a true blue brother. And I've been to many places you'll never discover. Step to my side, suckers running hot. Africa's in the house, they get petrified.
Later on, they introduced me to a kid named Q-Tip.
Okay.
So I'm meeting different people at the time. This was far before the Tribe Called Quest album came to be. I wasn't there for the meeting, but Africa told me that, yo, it's some kids out in Long Island. They're pretty cool. They're called De La Soul. And, you know, we're gonna link up with them because we're on the same type of vibe.
What?
In that meeting, somebody came up with the name Native Tongue. Q-Tip started jumping on different records on Jungle, on De La, and that was kind of his introduction that, you know, this kid is coming, Q-Tip.
Hello, it's the soul, trooping in with the Jungle Patrol, and this one's about the KOs, the knockouts out there who I call my buddy.
Hold up, just wait. So from there, we move into, okay, I'm a DJ. I need to get in where I fit in. Jungle Brothers is doing their album. They have a group. You got Tip. He's in the background working on stuff. I was going to DJ for Queen Latifah. He had a DJ. I fit in. I was trying to get down with Nice and Smooth. I was trying to get down with everybody I can come in contact with. But, you know, these people already had the groups formed and everybody in place. So I started thinking, like, yo, let me reach back to these cats that I was dealing with in North Carolina that could rhyme.
Like, and I've left at this point. The week I finished high school, I came back to New York.
Okay.
So, you know, I hadn't seen Long in some years. And, you know, I kind of bumped my head, got into a little trouble here and there. And I'm trying to figure it out. Get back on track.
Stop right there. Got in a little trouble when you came back to New York?
Yeah, a little bit.
What you do? What, you got a key? You flipped it?
Dres,
why you do that?
Because I was young and foolish. That's exactly why.
All right, so you was out there hustling.
I did 10 months on Rikers, 10 months in a halfway house, and then the very next year, I'm working, going to school, just got my own apartment in the Bronx. I'm working for this agency, and I'm coming from lunch, and who do I walk by? Mr. Lawnge.
Mm-hmm.
On the street of Manhattan.
Wow.
And I'm like, what? You know, like, what up? You know what I'm saying? So,
it's the likeliness of this shit.
Exactly.
I'm like, yo, what up? How ironic is that?
Right.
On the street, yep. And I'm like, yo, I'm running hard with these rap cats. We need to do our own demo. Let's form our own group. But first and foremost, we have to come up with a group name. And I'm like, yo, the name of these cats are Native Tongues. I think we need to be the opposite of what they're doing. They're the positive pro-black dudes talking all this black stuff. Let's be the black sheep of the family.
And De La Soul, they were the ones who featured you on the album, weren't they?
Yeah, that was the first song I rhymed on, Fanatic of the B-Word. On a De La Soul album. And so the first time people heard me was on a De La Soul album.
Move over just a bit to the right of me. Right of who I cannot see. Cannot see. Where the booty is. I said I'm looking out a foggy window. Crack it just a bit. Yo, this is showbiz. It's as though a pound goes around and around. And so I give a pound. Give a pound. Then I do the step. Dres will be with Booker on the side. And I crack a smile for those who slept. Phonetics and kinetics persevere, therefore I kick it. I took the L-I-R-R, but I didn't have a ticket. Had some Chinese food, but I didn't have a spoon. I had a dope wine, but I didn't have it soon. I'm looking out the window, day is filled with rain and gloom. Man, oh man, oh man, I hope I find my spoon soon. Eating on some sushi, cause I know it ain't cat. It ain't cat.
This is a time when there was no sending each other tracks. Right. You know what I'm saying? We were together almost every single day. And it was so dope. To me, that's why a lot of those records sound how they sound. Mm-hmm. Because it was just something that was amongst all of us. It didn't matter whose session it was. We'd all come to the studio. Mm-hmm. We'd find out whose session it was when we got there. I didn't know any better, so I didn't know if that's how things were always done or if that's how things were always going to be done. But now that I'm older, I realize that it was just a really small piece of time that was just very unique.
With that being said, because I want to push pause on Black Sheep, I want to get into another record. So let's talk about another song that you produced.
Then they dropped another song called Flash's Theme later that year. You probably never heard of it. I know I never did. Listen.
And this is where we get into Black Sheep, the legendary duo. I believe that this would be the time where this is now your time to be on the worldwide big stage.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome to Case International. I'm Fakisha Kumbo. We have a rap show today with our special guest, Black Sheep, Mista Lawnge and Dres. Welcome to Case International.
It's a pleasure to finally meet her.
Okay. We're going to start rolling here with one of your really good videos. Kick it.
Van Damme. You see what kind of flavor I want? Do I want vanilla? Or do I want to taste the chocolate? I want something different. I want something slamming. What's the slamming flavor out this month? Let's see. Yo, Black. What flavor are you?
Listen. For a second, I reckon I got you double checking. Then again, when to your needs did I beckon? Hold me only if you wanna get naked. Play me for the crowd only if you wanna wreck it. The name is Dres, like silk I get slick. Drop rhymes like a bass head, big flicks constantly. Yes, it's me, D-R-E-S.
And we was intentionally looking for something that was going to be an introduction, you know what I'm saying? We was like, you know, that was kind of our mindset, like, you know, like we need a record that's going to introduce us. You know, I heard you got the fever for something new, the fever for the flavor, you know what I'm saying? Like, even though we're saying, like, innately, like, you know, flavor of the month is to say, like, you know, it's trendy.
Right.
Come on, I heard they got the fever for the flavor. I heard they got the fever for the flavor. I heard they got the fever. Nobody said we had it going on.
Sheep was the first hip-hop group to be on Tonight Show. And why did it take them so long to finally have a hip-hop group on?
I remember when I heard the first beat on television, on a commercial. Like you know, like we kind of forget, like we kind of take it for granted at this point, but hip-hop used to be something that you just heard on the radio late at night on the weekends. There was nothing on the radio during the day. There was nothing on television. Let alone, you know, it being used in a commercial or something to that degree. It didn't even exist. I remember when I just heard a beat on television.
On a Jay Leno show.
At the end of the day, you know, we felt like it was really the perfect introduction, you know what I'm saying? Even like Long's intro, which kind of got us in a little bit of trouble initially, where he's like, you know, what do I want a flavor of? And, you know, this, that, and the other.
The beginning of Flavor of the Month record, Mr. Lawnge is like, what do I want? Some vanilla ice, or do I want to taste the chocolate?
You see what kind of flavor I want? Do I want vanilla, or do I want to taste the chocolate? I want something different. I want something slamming.
Now, Vanilla Ice had, you know, everyone knows him, and A Taste of Chocolate was the name of Big Daddy Kane's album. So I turned along, and I'm like, yo, dude, like, it doesn't sound cool what you just said. Like, you know, it's almost like, you know, like you're almost trying to diss these cats. And I'm a huge Kane fan. Like, you know, like, is that what you're trying to do? So he assures me, nah. I'm just saying, like, you know, we're something different. We're the new flavor. When this record comes out, everyone is coming up to me like, yo, including Kane's brother. Like, yo, everyone thinks you're dissing Kane, this and the other. We're new artists. And it's Big Daddy Kane who's like, Big Daddy Kane, like, yo, no, I'm not dissing me. So I had to break down to Kane's brother, Shane, like, yo, my dude, I approached my man about that. I said, yo, you know, like, yo, I gotta see your brother. Like, yo, he gotta know, like, yo, I'm a huge fan of Kane. Like, yo, there was definitely no malice meant in that. He was just trying to say that we're something new.
All types of people from all walks of life tell us they get different things out of our music. And God knows we get different things from different people's music, you know. And we look at it as just music. We don't really try to put it all into, you know, rap, this, that, you know, into distinct categories. It's all music.
No further ado, I give introduction. I'm Dres and Mista Lawnge, a newfound baby sound production. I'm not out to vic you, to strip or evict you, but merely do the things you wanted to but weren't able. Like move a 40 side to side, sway for sway, and stride for stride. First find tune, then hit volume. Oh, sheep hit the bass and got the boom. So move to a rhythm that's quite uplifting. Just when you thought that nothing would arise, I'm drifting higher. Yeah, higher. I'm not a king, a prince, a ruler, or a squire. I'm not a prophet and I'm not a messiah. I'm not a wolf or another flat tire. Listen.
Would you call your music hardcore rap?
I wouldn't call it hardcore. I would just call it dope.
Your lyrics come from I won't say the concept isn't different, but the way you bring it off, I think, is different. Because, you know, you deal with the bold words. In other words, you will curse, you will say, you know, a lot of words that I don't think you can ever get played on television or the radio.
The Sugar Dick Daddy, Mr. Lawnge, to break it down. Ladies, step to me for a real neat treat. And if you don't want to call me Lawnge, you can call me Sweet Meat. I wear protection, you won't catch claps here. Come over later, but first go get a pap smear. 9.5, okay dear? And don't forget clean underwear. Cause I don't want the funk to flow. And after I nut, yo, you gotta go. Don't you know, ho? Don't you know, ho?
Now, have you been called, like, sexist or conceited or misogynistic, in other words, you know, anti-woman?
Basically, every time we approach like that, it's because whoever someone listened to the album didn't listen to the album. Yeah. They just heard it. They didn't try to understand.
We were so upfront and blatant about it. Society is a racist, sexist place. Deal it in every form and fashion in different ways every day. From not being able to catch a cab to, you know, to being talked about behind your back, you know, to whatever, just when you're not around or just how society feels about you on a whole. And we were just really upfront about it, and we were really, like, real blatant. We blew a lot of pictures. We painted a lot of pictures. We didn't draw the pictures ourselves. We just colored it in.
Okay.
You know?
All right. That really sounds all cool and really everything. But now, let's deal with, like, the issue of using the word hoe and hoes. I mean, what's the necessity for that? What's the deal with that?
To do like I do, being Mr. Lawnge, it's time to get deep.
You're going to wreck them for the situation?
As long as we can keep it on the television.
You know what I'm saying?
You know. Go ahead.
Like, if we talk about a hoe, that's not like saying we're talking about
women. Women and womankind.
We're not talking about womankind when we talk about a hoe. We're talking about a hoe that we know.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We're not the hoe we're talking about. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, but then why is it that it's important in your music to talk about your sexual organs or your sexual powers or that kind of thing?
Basically,
I should ask Mr. Lawnge.
She's talking like a whole album consisted.
No, if the whole album did, we wouldn't have been able to play these two great videos that we're going to play.
True.
So
exactly.
I won't say that the whole album is.
Right.
But it's enough on there that turned my head around.
Out of the 22 cuts on the album, about four is somewhat explicit.
No. You gotta be more than four.
Like I said, some people just hear the album, they don't listen.
Boomin' WA, think I'm lying, black, I'm crying. Salted tear with turns of crystal. Crystals forming on my dishes, so I wash until dismissal. Wash until my prints are wrinkled, then they let me go. I know not where I'm going, so I know not where I go. My people give me money, but the money much too low for me to meet the match of present day, so I still need more dough. Conjure up a suit, I wish that it were cute. Borrow a token and a smoking, I begin a wishless go. Interview and application lead me on into frustration, and duration of my time is spent in lack of occupation. Time to go for what I know. I know not of a wish, but of soap and a towel and some water and a dish. Don't speak to me of good times or grand that shall I be. Don't tell me of the countries over islands that you see. Don't tell me to keep trying, you know I won't agree. Double negative means positively black with envy.
Like I'll vibe with the music before I ever write to it.
Mm.
Like, you know, I want it to be something that I want to hear again with no lyrics. It might just be a little pebble. And then my job becomes to make it a rock.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's awesome. So now let's go ahead and get into the big record. The one that the whole world at this point said, you know what, Black Sheep, this is the record that we love. It's an undeniable, timeless classic. Talk to me about how you constructed this particular record.
I kind of approached everything like I was going to be a one-man band. I had a beat. The beat was the New Birth drums. Very simple. One, two. Okay, so then I pulled out, I think it was Sweet Linda Devine, which was another beat, but then she was saying, come on.
I'm saying, all right, come on.
And then I used the Iron Butterfly to think, think. I actually put it on 45 to make it even faster than the original song.
So let's talk about the diamond in the rough in this slew of samples. The bass line is the killer. I have the original record. It's not like it just starts with the bass line. It's not like it's just there. You had to listen to this long jazz record to find when it drops, and it drops quickly and it's gone.
Rip, you're a DJ. I'm a DJ. We're from back in the days.
Right.
We use records. You know, when the grooves are dark on a record, that's the breakdown. So that's what I go to first. Check the beginning, check the dark grooves in the middle, check the dark grooves at the end. That's how you search for the breaks. So I was like, yo, it's dark grooves damn near at the end of the record. I dropped the needle. I heard a couple of bass solos. I said, none of those fit. So I pulled it back even further to the beginning of it, of the breakdown. Then I heard it. I was like, that might work. So I just started looping it. I wanted it to be longer than one bar, but the next bar the record was off. And I was like, nah, that's not going to work. So I said, I'll just use one bar.
Engine number 9 on the New York Transit line. If my train falls off the track, pick it up. Back on the scene, crispy and clean. You can try, but then why? Cause you can't intervene. Yo, we be the outcasts, down for the settle. Won't play rock, won't play the pebble. Open the door, you best believe we're sliding through this swift.
Late.
Come on. Mentally, so we can make it. Tip to be what we are, not what we be. City of pitch to be. Right? Come on. Now I dwell just the same flavor. Holy injustice, I got the container. Pass the plate up, close the fader. Black ship can play like a Sony in a trailer. Ever the traitor, party inflator.
And you can get a scoop later. You can get with this, or you can get with that. You can get with this, or you can get with that. You can get with this.
When this comes on, like, it's just this feeling in my body that, you know, it's a party, you know, wherever it is, it's gonna rock. That was a beautiful, beautiful era in hip hop.
Definitely.
And get some vibes on that, Ace. Let me get some vibes. That's ridiculous. Yo, do you understand what I'm saying? You know how necessary y'all are?
In 1991, if you heard this beat drop and these nursery rhyme bars,
Engine number 9 on the New York Transit line. If my train goes off the track, pick it up.
It was lights out, y'all. Holy shit, fam. I remember being in my high school semi-formal, and when that drop came on, everything burned down in the Much Music video dance. Much Music video dance. Yeah, I just said that. It was lit back then. If you ain't from Canada, then you probably have no idea what I'm talking about.
Now we're going to blast one for you.
Crazy Hap, let's go.
Go, boys.
You can turn your event into the event simply by hiring the Much Music Video Dance Party.
Rolling right along with your own special brand of music.
After the Flavor of the Month, we're going into the second single, which was Choice Is Yours. There's, you know, there's the original and there's the revisited version.
I liked the album version and I wanted the album version to be the second single.
I wanted something to compete with what I was hearing in the clubs.
Who's the black sheep? What's the black sheep? No, not who I am or when I'm coming, so you sleep. Wasn't in my realm or wasn't in your sphere. Knew not who I was, but listen here.
So that was about the hardest record we had.
And the real reason why I remixed is because the album was on hold for a year. When I went back and listened to it, I was like, I'm not so keen on that sound right now.
When he plays me this track, I'm blown away. And he tells me, yeah, this was something I had gave to Chi, but he ain't like it. It
was almost a Chi Ali record.
I don't really remember, but I know Long used to, you know, he used to play beats for me all the time.
And that literally sparked me and Long having a serious conversation like, look, do not ever play anything for anybody until you play it for me first.
This is here to stay.
It's a blessing, you know. It's not something I could have ever foreseen. It's like, people like it. Something I did as a kid 25 years ago.
Like, that shit is a fucking classic joint, yo. Like, that shit is top three, top five hip-hop records ever, in my opinion.
I can't tell you literally the thousands of people that have come up to me over the years and told me what that song means to them and where they were, you know, from high school to college to, man, I mean, it's just something that really touches you where you feel like, you know, like they got it, like, you know, like they got it and it means something to them, like it means something to you. Mr. Long Dress, Black Sheep Slam
now. A lot of people don't know that a wolf in sheep's clothing went gold, right?
It went platinum at this point.
Wow. That's
but it went gold
dope.
Back, you know, it went gold back then, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, you know, another shout to Mr. Long. Like Long was, you know, was just truly a dope producer. You know, in the making of that first album and, you know, and even the second, you know, like, the second doesn't really get the accolades because a lot of different things were going on. The whole label was
being
restructured.
Right. Y'all had the sophomore jinx.
You know what? Honestly, I wouldn't even say it was because, you know, like, I listened to the project, you know, in retro, mm-hmm. and it's dope. It's just not a wolf in sheep's clothing.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? A lot of times people get... People try to make you, they want you to do part two of what you did. And we very intentionally didn't do part two.
Black sheep in your house, party people you remember. The two that serve your whole crew like the bartender. It's Dynamic D. Don't you panic because we won't stop until hip hop is all it could be. Now, you can't check it when I flex it, yo, I wreck. You're turning me off like a naked anorexic. I Jazzy baby, if you're blasting, maybe you can see me. You missed the long to drop the flavor loops like you can.
It's the genuine nine and then some. Rolling with the sheep, but yo, we all can't come. Because the party be on that old strict clientele. This and more people at the door than Jessica and Miguel. Now if you peeps up the sheep, then we'll let you in. But if you didn't buy my album, then you're not my friend.
What happened with Nonfiction's lack of success? Because like at that point, like I had did a lot of production on Nonfiction, and you know it took me a minute to grasp all of the things that were above my head that took place in the process of what was going on. I had kind of stepped back from doing beats after Nonfiction because I felt like I needed to just concentrate on what I do.
I guess everybody wanted us to make a wolf in sheep's clothing too, which was doable. But at the end of the day, like, I felt like, you know, there's so much more to us than just, you know, that particular color, you know? And it is what it is.
They call it the sophomore jinx. But we had a lot of stuff internally going on with the record company.
After the Black Sheep record, I went to a different record label and I worked really hard. I didn't have the same success that I had at Mercury with the Black Sheep.
Even me and Long's relationship had become a little strained and what have you.
As far as Black Sheep, we went our separate ways pretty much because of creative differences. That's the bottom line.
What was the gift and maybe even the curse behind having that?
The gift and the curse of the choice is yours. The curse of it is probably as blatant
I would definitely say success has something to do with the diminishment of probably me and Long's relationship.
Mm.
You know? And you know, that doesn't feel good, you know, at some points in life. You know, you have to accept what it is. But at the same time, it doesn't necessarily make it feel any better.
All right.
You know what I'm saying?
And the group broke up in 95, is that correct?
95, the record company dissolved everything. Whoever Def Jam does not pick is going to be out. You know, me and Dres had our own little personal whatever, nothing major, but the catalyst was the dissolving of the record company.
So you didn't try to go get another record deal or any of that?
Certain people got marked as being a problem.
Okay.
Kind of getting on a blacklist, you know what I'm saying? And record company's like, nah, these guys use samples, it costs a lot. And everybody's kind of hesitant.
Well, you know, sometimes in relationships, people grow in different ways.
Okay.
Sometimes in relationships, people grow faster than ever.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes in relationships, you realize that it's not healthy, that it's toxic.
Mr. Lawnge was toxic, huh?
No, I'm not calling him toxic. I mean, you know, it could have been me at times.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not
fair
you
enough.
Know, I'm not faulting him in any way. As much as I'm saying that I'm happy today,
mm-hmm.
and I hope he is too. It's been over 10 years that we haven't been together, but that doesn't mean that, you know, I don't wish him the best. And if we were able, I would love for us to put something together.
You're not able?
When, you know, we all have exes. We all have relationships that we had years ago. We're not trying to find them.
Niggas was saying in the hood that, you know, you was sleeping with his girl or something like that. That's true? I'm not looking at that.
They say what is what was. But what was could never be. Ain't nothing new under the sun. Y'all ain't doing nothing but some shit I already did. Tell you where you going. Yeah. Said I'm not gon' say you, y'all, I'm gon' say we. Sometimes I sit and think about it, yo, how numb could we be? How could it go so far, how'd it get so funky? That we could walk a mile of footsteps of a porch monkey. That we could break.
Because a lot of artists lose it.
Which is success.
When they continue to try, though. For a lot of artists, they end up falling off and getting disrespected a little bit. Because what you remember was them still forcing out these records that you're like, oh, no, that's not it.
Yeah.
You know, you're another example. You decided in, like, after Without a Doubt, whatever it was, when you started doing Dres the Black Sheep solo stuff,
mm-hmm.
it was to college radio, it was to underground, it was to Europe. Yeah. You were just like, that's where I'm going to go.
I mean, honestly, and that's because everyone's perception of success isn't the same. Like, when I was young, my perception of success wasn't to be what Jay-Z and Puff are. I didn't care to be a 100 millionaire, like, or the first billionaire.
Not
like,
to mention that you couldn't have even fathomed it back
first,
then.
Yeah. Honestly, there were no millionaires in the game back then.
Right.
Silly, none. But that wasn't my idea. That wasn't who I wanted to be.
We can all get sweaty, then take showers, and get sweaty again for 17 hours. We can all get sweaty, then take showers, and get sweaty again for 17 hours. From a fantasy to a nightmare, 17 hours.
What did you spend your time doing after the Black Sheep, after Black Sheep broke up?
Just doing remixes and different tracks for different people. But like I said, nothing career defining.
Got you.
Just throwing beats and running people down like, yo, I got this. Yeah, I'm trying to hustle beats pretty much.
You know what I'm saying? And even now, like, you know, I'm not an artist that you hear with platforms and this, that, and the other, but I'm all over the world, literally, doing shows every year. And for me to still be doing this 25 years later...
That's a blessing.
And making a blessing. Yeah, right. I'm from Astoria Projects. I'm from the Bland and Flushing. Like, for me to be doing what I've been doing for 25 years and that feeding me and my family...
Mm.
Yo, I'm so happy.
I'm feeling you.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And I didn't see that coming.
Mm-hmm.
You know, especially when we first started. Like, I couldn't see that. So for me to still be doing what I love and know that I got into it for reasons that had nothing to do with a check. Right. Mm-hmm. Man, I'm very happy. I feel like, you know, like I have a purpose and absolutely. I live up to it. And,
you're,
you know,
necessary.
Saying?
I told you that. Just to let you know, I bought a Kia after.
Oh yeah. You know, like there's movies that Detroit is yours is in, like, you know, and I mean, this is every year. Right now, there's an Airheads commercial that's you know, that we get publishing on.
Right.
You know, like every few years, you know, saying it's introduced to a new generation.
Here, man.
Damn, they look like the girls from the candy shop videos.
They might look like them, man, but man, they don't dance like them.
Oh, yeah? So, you been working them out?
Come on. I've been working them out. Let me hear you.
Let me laugh. That's what she showed you? Hey, yo.
The choice is yours. You can get with this, or you can get with that.
At a time where I felt like, you know, like it was cool to have fun, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't such a bravado about, you know what I'm saying, having fun. I mean, it wasn't so much that, you know, you had to make a street anthem or a club banger or a radio record. You just had to make good music.
Right.
You really got your accolades by sounding like no one else, even though it might be reminiscent of something, you know what I'm saying? Whereas these days, I feel like cats get their accolades and props by sounding just like someone. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, that sounds just like the last record I heard on the radio. I love him.
Yeah.
Like, you don't do something, like I said, you can do something you think is the dopest project in the world, and you put it out, and it does nothing, and then everybody's looking at it as a failure. So, oh, that must be whack. It didn't work, so it must be whack. See what I mean? People don't, there's no real music lovers out there anymore. It's just a bunch of lovers of money and success.
I look at a lot of music that's current as rap music.
not necessarily hip-hop. I feel like hip-hop is cultural. I feel like hip-hop is something that you can grow from. Hip-hop is something that will instill something that you can take home, you know, or a perspective that you can grow into. Rap music is corporate. Rap music is, how can I sell something? How can I make you buy into something? Not even necessarily something that's healthy. And it's become something that we don't even care if it's detrimental or helpful. You know what I'm saying? These kids would rather be broken than be broke. And they have to grow through that. And they will. Hip hop is still growing.
If you're doing it for the money, stop. If you're doing it for the love and you can get an audience from it that loves what you're doing, then you're on the right path.
In my opinion, that's why a lot of the music from our era still stands.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, we got into it for the right reason. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? We got into it for the right reason.
I skipped the line, I paid my dime, I hung my coat, and now it's time to move to the forefront, make my round, say peace and give a pound, have a drink, get down. I'm on the floor, besides the door, the sound is rich.
Similac, similac, now drop the voice, president.
Now when I first saw ya, I really thought I knew ya. But now I see I don't, and I wish that I did. Yo, honey made a right step, off, took flight, upstairs, up some more, she made a left, and hit. Look down at my shoes and the cuff of my slacks. I know I got style and that the sheep can attract.
What?
Came out with something sticking, double mint, you know it. Yo, you think my breath was sticking?
So?
Not in the bathroom, I go and fixing his throat.
The sugar, daddy, Mr. Long.
Yo, what's up, mister?
Yeah.
Smacking his fist up.
Uh-huh.
Say, keep punching despite the liquid cup. Cause we're all the one, gotta get the job done. Now come on, cousin, let's go have some fun.
Okay.
The spot it isn't whack, yo. The toilet holds tobacco. That's all I need to see, yo. I'm reaching for a Philly to arrange. I look at Long, he looks at me.
What?
He doesn't say a word, and damn, it feels strange.
Yeah.
Walking through the crowd, pollution's got me choking. Funny that I'm choking, yo. Could it be that I'm smoking?